BC Ordaz is also covering the 4th Congressional District, and another candidate is Doug Ossie, of course, and it doesn't look good at the moment for Doug Ossie. Leticia?
Well, I'm here at the Ossie camp, and there is a big celebration tonight, but they are not ready to declare victory just yet. Joining me live now is Doug Ossie himself. Doug, how are you feeling tonight?
I'm doing fine, Leticia. This is exciting. So let's get the votes counted. Let's figure it out.
Why this race has not been a slam dunk for you?
This hasn't been a slam dunk because there's never a race that's a slam dunk. I mean, you go out and you take your message about trying to make things better, that you live in the area, that you're a businessman, that you've got experience, that you have this vast local network. I mean, you talk about solving problems. The other candidates make their case. These things are never a slam dunk.
Tell me the difference between you and your opponent, Tom McClintock.
Well, you know, that campaign's over. Let's just count the votes and figure out who won. Then let's coalesce and let's take Charlie Brown.
All right. Tell me about those undecided voters, because you are really trying to reach out to them.
You came by the headquarters. I mean, I had like 45 or 50 people all afternoon, today, yesterday, the day before, calling folks. And there was this large body of undecided voters in the district who just hadn't made up their mind. So we kept asking and asking and asking and asking and asking. And then when we got tired of asking, we asked some more about, look, here's the difference. This is where I am. I was born and raised here. I'm a businessman. I know the district. I know the issues. I know the people. Drawing a contrast with my opponent. Now, whatever the outcome today, either I'm going to do it or my opponent's going to do it, and we're going to draw the same kind of contrast with Charlie Brown, where we're talking about lowering taxes and he's talking about raising them, where we're talking about sealing the border and he's talking about giving these people amnesty, we're talking about fixing the economy and he's talking about who knows what. So that's what campaigns are about, reaching out to people and getting them to vote.
And tell me why you decided to get back into politics after retiring as a congressman.
Well, I mean, I don't think it's any secret to anybody. I don't like the direction this country's headed right now, especially at the legislative level. I think Speaker Pelosi and Senator Reid have taken us in a direction that at best is a cul-de-sac and at worst is a disaster. And we need to figure out a way to make those tax cuts permanent, and they're not talking about that. We need to figure out a way to increase oil production and expand refinery capacity, and they're not talking about that. We need to figure out a way to confront terrorism around the world, and all we're doing is considering non-binding resolutions of disapproval. That's got to stop. We got to solve these problems. We're the United States of America, and we need to face up to the fact that we have responsibilities, and the rest of the world looks to us to lead. We need to lead. Let's get on with it.
You're the man to do it.
I do believe I'm the man to do it. I've been there before. We fixed the economy in the late 90s from the dot-com bust. I can do it again.
Thank you so much for
nice to see you. Thanks, Leticia.
Thank you. All right, you heard it yourself. Mr. Ossie says that he is the man for this district because he is very familiar here. He lives in the area, and he says he will always make himself available to the public, he says, unlike his opponent. So that is the very latest here in Loomis. I'm Leticia Ordaz, KCRA 3 reports.